Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great Excel video today. Three items I'm going to cover. One, workbook stats, which shows up on your status bar. Item two is how to hide and show a chart. And item three, really cool, we're going to do the rank function in Excel, but using COUNTIF inside of it. Let's go ahead and dive into this video right now, and feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. So I've got a simple Excel file running here. I've got a bunch of numbers in column B. Here's what's so cool. If you notice that Ford is sitting here at 700 in my chart, it is the last item. If I go make Ford 1200, which is the largest value, when I press enter, it now shows up at the bar chart at the top. There's the 1200, and it's showing me what percentage it is running across the top. So this is a dynamic chart. It also shows me the grand total of all the items. So if I highlight these just to test it, look in your status bar in the bottom right corner, there is the sum 5,000, so that is correct. Which leads me to this point. If I don't want to see this chart on my screen, right clicking inside of it doesn't do any good. There's no hide in there. So if you want to hide the chart, you just go to the Home tab, over to the far right is the Editing group, Find and Select, you pull up your selection pane, all your objects will be in there. I only have one called Chart 1. There is Hide. That is how you can hide and show a chart. You also have Hide All. If I had multiple charts, I would hide them and show all. If I had images in here or callouts, it would also be showing up over here. So there is your selection pane. Regardless of whether I hid the chart or not, I like to pull up workbook stats back on my status bar at the bottom. Right click, and there is your workbook stats. Check it. It shows up on your status bar in the bottom left corner. And if I click on it, cool feature here. I've covered this before. Two different groups. It shows me the current worksheet, and it says, hey, you've got a chart. And again, if I hit the chart, it will still say, I've got a chart, and it'll say the number one. And then it's got your stats for the entire workbook or file also in it. So I have a total of six charts in this file. Close that out. So that's another nice feature I like to have running when people send me files. I like to go to workbook stats and just see what's in the worksheet and workbook. Now, the only way I could make this chart work, just so you know this, is using the rank function, but also using COUNTIF with it. So let me go show the rank function with COUNTIF right here. If you notice, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to hide the chart again real quick just to keep the screen clean. And then I'm going to hide this data right here. I selected the columns and hide the data. You can tell they're hidden. They go from D to J. So the rank function, real simple. Delete that out of there. Delete it all. Equals rank dot, you want to use the EQ. I want to know cell B3, that's the first cell with the number. What rank is it? And I highlighted the entire range of B3 to B7. I'm going to make an absolute reference with the F4 key, and it is rank number 2. Crosshairs, pull down. You're saying, Chris, isn't that what you just had? No. Here's the issue with the rank function. Right now, Ford is number one with 1,200, and here's GM, 800. But what happens when I have a tie? The rank function is working correctly, and it's showing both Ford and GM tied at first, and then Kia comes in third. So when I did this, that chart wouldn't work because that chart had XLOOKUP in it, but I could have done VLOOKUP, or I could have done index and match. It kept showing me Ford twice because it didn't know that to put GM in it. So I needed this to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for that chart. So to do this, I'm just going to edit this function, and I'm going to say plus count if cell B3 through B3, comma, my criteria is B3. and I subtracted one. And I do need to make this first one absolute reference. But I don't need to make the second one, B3 colon B3, the second one stays as relative. And the comma B3, the argument, the criteria stays as relative. So there's that function right there. I got 3 again, no big deal, but watch this. 3, 4, 1, 2, 5. In case you're wondering, why did it give it a 2? Let's just dive into that. Formulas tab. Let's do evaluate formula. Evaluate. So it took the rank of cell B6, and then it found it to be number 1, because it was just by default with the rank function. If you recall, that was the number 1. So then it moved on to do a count if, and it said, hey, we're going to do a count if of this range. Well, the number 1200 shows up twice. 1 plus 2, the rank is 1. We found the number 1200 twice. That's 3 minus 1 gave us the 2. Cool? So that is how I was able to build that chart, which I'll make in another video. I'll go and show you how I did that. We're getting into Excel Advanced because we're going to reference the rank function, and then we're going to do an X lookup. And we're also going to add percentages to create that chart. So it all ties together. But anyway, Workbook Stats was really simple. Right click, turn them on. The chart was dynamic. I showed you that. I showed you the rank function with count if in it also. Have a great day. Again, feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. And I really do appreciate your support for my channel. Thank you.